Hey guys, welcome to all of you on our channel, that is Achieve IAS. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the exam of civil services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So in this video we will be talking about our current affair MCQ series, in which what we do, we daily discuss MCQs from your current affair perspective. So today is 2nd October, so let's see what are the questions for today. The first question is, consider the following statements. First, under the FRBM Act, that is Fiscal Responsibility and Budget Management Act, the fiscal deficit is to be brought down to zero. Second statement is, NK Singh Committee was set up by the government to review the FRBM Act. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Let me tell you friends that only one statement is correct, and that is second. So the answer would be B. So second only. So primary objective is to basically eliminate the revenue deficit and bringing down the fiscal deficit. So other objectives are also there, like introduction for transparent system of fiscal management within the country and ensuring equitable distribution of debt over the years, ensuring fiscal stability in the long run. And then act also intended to give the required flexibility to the central bank for managing inflation in India. So features are basically macroeconomic framework statement, medium term fiscal policy statement, fiscal policy strategy statement, and these must be placed along with budget documents annually in the parliament. So it was proposed that the four fiscal indicators, that is revenue deficit as a percentage of GDP, fiscal deficit, tax revenue and total outstanding liabilities be projected in the medium term fiscal policy statement. So various targets are there. So revenue, first target is that revenue deficit has to be eliminated by 31st of March 2009. So minimum annual reduction that has been targeted is 0.5% of the GDP, and fiscal deficit is to be brought down to at least 3% of GDP by 31st of March 2018. A minimum annual reduction of 0.3% of GDP. So obviously these targets have not been met as yet. So in 2016, NK Singh Committee was set up by the government to review this FRBM Act. So the task was to review the performance of this act and to suggest necessary changes to the provisions of the act. So recommendations of the committee read that the government must target a fiscal deficit of 3% of the GDP in the year up to March 31, 2020, subsequently cut it to 2.8% in 2020-21. So the fiscal deficit target of 2019-20 budget is 3.3%. So but in this committee it was suggested that it must be brought down to 3% and then subsequently 2.8% in 2021 and 2.5% by 2023. So let's move on to the next question. Next is, school education quality index is published by which of the following? A, Niti Aayog; B, Ministry of Human Resources; C, Ministry of Skill Development; D, none of the above. So we have to choose the correct statement answer. Let me tell you friends that the answer is Niti Aayog. So it has been recently released, in which you might have read in a newspaper that Kerala topped, but if we take overall performance, then Chandigarh is at the top. So it is released by Niti Aayog. It is to evaluate the performance of states as well as union territories in school education sector. So 30 critical indicators are assessed and then they are categorized as outcomes and then governance process aiding outcomes. So significance is basically schooling should result in successful learning outcomes. So in this regard, it acts as a credible system of assessment and helps to design necessary remedial actions. So different ways are there in which the states are ranked, but let's see what the performance of the various states. So Kerala has emerged on top among 20 last states in terms of quality of school education, followed by Rajasthan, Karnataka, while the most populous UP was ranked at the bottom position during 2016-17. So among 20 large states in the country, 18 have improved overall performance between 2015-16 and 16-17. So which is otherwise referred to as incremental performance in the report. So highest incremental performance has been recorded in Kerala, so as against 77.6% in 2015-16. So the state has recorded 82.2% in 2016-2017. So the overall performance has declined in Karnataka and Uttarakhand, and all 7 UTs have shown an improvement in their overall performance scores, and the performance and ranks have decreased in Mizoram, Sikkim and Arunachal Pradesh. So let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements about index of industrial production. First, the base year for calculating this index is 2011-12. Second, the highest weightage is given to manufacturing sector. So which of the above statements is correct? Let me tell you, friend, that both of these statements are correct. So the answer is C. So both 1 and 2, basically base year for calculating it is 2011-12, and it highest weightage is basically given to manufacturing sector. So obviously it is in an index of industrial production, so obviously highest weightage will go to manufacturing sector. So it is an index which helps understand the growth of various sectors in Indian economy, such as mining, electricity and manufacturing. So it is a short-term indicator of industrial growth till the results from annual survey of industries and the national account statistics are available. So the base year of the index is given a value of 100. So the current base year for this index is 2011-12. So if the current IIP reads 180, it means that there has been 80% industrial growth compared to the base year, that is 2011-12. So who releases this? Basically it is released by Central Statistical Office and the Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation. So it is published monthly, 6 weeks after the reference month ends. So next is fourth question. Consider the following statements related to National Nutrition Survey. First, it is conducted by Ministry of Health and Family Welfare with the assistance of UNICEF. Second, the survey recorded only the malnutrition deficiency. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. And let me tell you, friends, the answer should be... let me check. It is conducted by Ministry of yes, first is correct, but not second. So it is basically conducted by Ministry of Health and Family Welfare with the assistance of UNICEF. So basically this the first ever comprehensive national nutrition survey. So it recorded malnutrition that included micronutrient deficiencies and details of non-communicable diseases such as diabetes, hypertension, cholesterol and kidney function in children and adolescents. So key findings are that 10% of the children in the age group of 5 to 9% and adolescents in the group of 10 to 19 years are pre-diabetic, 5% of them are overweight, and then 5% suffered from blood pressure. So the survey for the first time proved the coexistence of obesity and undernutrition. So 1 in 5 children in the age group of 5 to 9 years were stunted. So it is quite concerning number, because obviously it amounts to 20%. And then Tamil Nadu and Goa had the highest number of adolescents who were obese or overweight. So steps taken by the government of India, like Pradhan Mantri Matru Vandana Yojana is there. 6,000 is transferred directly to the bank accounts of pregnant women for availing better services for the delivery. And then Poshan Abhiyan was launched. So then National Food Security Act is there, Midday Meal Scheme is there, and then Integrated Child Development Services are also there, scheme is there, ICDS, which provides nutrition through Anganwadi centers. So then there is also United Nations Decade on Nutrition. It started from 2016 and will continue till 2025. Led by WHO and Food and Agriculture Organization, the UN Decade of Action on Nutrition calls for policy actions across six key areas: creating sustainable, resilient food systems for healthy diets, providing social protection, aligning health systems to nutrition needs, ensuring that trade and investments policies improve nutrition, building safe and supportive environment for nutrition, and strengthening and promoting nutrition governance accountability everywhere. Let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements. First, Bandipur National Park is in the state of Karnataka. Second, National Highway 7 and National Highway 8 are passing through this national park. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Only one statement is correct, and that is first, that is Bandipur National Park is in the state of Karnataka. So basically it was recently in news because Kerala CM has requested union minister for your highways to kind of open this the night traffic on the highway that passes through this Bandipur National Park in state of Karnataka. So it was established in 1974 as a tiger reserve under Project Tiger, and it is now a national park located in the state of Karnataka. and it is also the state with the second highest tiger population in India, and it is one of the premier tiger reserves in the country along with the adjoining Nagarhole National Park. So NH-181 and NH-766 passes through these parks. So basically these are the more details, so you can read about them. So basically Kerala condemns the night ban and has asked for the ban to be lifted to save a reroute that increases the distance by 45 km. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements. First, electoral bond is a promissory note carrying interest with them. Second, it will carry the name of the payee. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Let me tell you friends that both of these statements are wrong. Answer is D, neither one nor two. Basically electoral bonds it was recently in news because this has started at the authorized branches of State Bank of India. So these are the basically bonds that allow donors to pay political parties using banks as an intermediary. So although called a bond, banking instrument resembling promissory note and not, but it will not carry any interest. So it will be a bearer instrument and will not carry the name of the payee. It can be bought any value in multiples of rupees 1000, 10,000, rupees 1 lakh and rupees 10 lakh and rupees 1 crore. So you can read about it in more detail. So there is a little bit controversy also associated with it. You can pause the video and can see the detail. Next is, consider the following statements related to gold bond scheme. First, the government introduced these bonds to help reduce India's over dependence upon gold imports. Second, bonds can be used for collateral, can be used as collateral for loans. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Let me tell you friends that both of these statements are correct. So basically gold bond scheme is basically introduced to help reduce India's over dependence on gold imports and can also be used as a collateral. So will be sold through scheduled commercial banks, that is small finance banks, except small finance banks and payment banks. Stock Holding Corporation of India Limited, designated post offices and recognized stock exchanges, that is the National Stock Exchange of India Limited and Bombay Stock Exchange Limited. So basically it was introduced in 2015 to help reduce India's over dependence on gold imports. So it also aims at changing the habit of Indians from saving in physical form of gold to a paper form with sovereign backing. So more details you can read by pausing the video. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, National Crisis Management Committee is headed by A. Prime Minister, B. Home Minister, C. Cabinet Secretary, D. None of the above. Let me tell you friends that the answer is Cabinet Secretary. So this National Crisis Management Committee for effective implementation of relief measures in the wake of national natural calamities. So Government of India has set up a National Crisis Management Committee and Cabinet Secretary is its chairman. So other members will be secretaries of the all concerned ministries, departments as well as organizations are the members of the committee. So it gives the direction to the crisis management group as deemed necessary. Now let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements. First, BrahMos missile has been jointly developed by India and Russia and it is named after the rivers Brahmaputra and Moskva in Russia. And second is, it is supersonic missile, cruise missile capable of launching from land, sea and air. So which of the above statements is correct? Let me tell you friends that both of these statements is correct. Answer is C, that is both 1 and 2. So it is basically, it flies almost 3 times the speed of the sound at Mach 2.8 and has a range of 290 km. So it was jointly developed, it has been jointly developed by Russia and India and are named and is named after rivers Brahmaputra and Moskva in Russia. So it is extremely difficult to be intercepted by surface-to-air missiles deployed on leading warships around the world. So the range can be extended up to 400 km as certain technical restrictions were lifted after India became a full member of Missile Technology Control Regime, that is MTCR, in 2016. So it is a multi-platform and it can be launched from land, air and sea and multi-capability missile with pinpoint accuracy that works in both day and night irrespective of the weather conditions. Now let's move on to the next question. Next is, which state tops the National Tourism Award 2017-18? A. Tamil Nadu, B. Andhra Pradesh, C. Madhya Pradesh, D. Telangana. Friends, answer is Andhra Pradesh. So more details you can read in this data. So link has been shared with you. You can check this link. And friends, this is all about today's discussion about these daily MCQs. So if you like this discussion, if you like this video, then do ensure that you like our video, share it with your friends, and also ensure that you subscribe to our channel. And also, friends, if you want to remain in touch with the various updates that that are taken by us for the purpose of CSE, then you can join our public Telegram channel, the link of which is shown on your screen and will also be provided in the description box. So if in case you want to remain in touch with us, then you are more than welcome to join our public Telegram channel. And lastly, if you have any queries, if you have any doubts, you can contact us at 8968920720, or you can also mail us at achieveies21@gmail.com. So friends, also if you wish to subscribe to the PDFs of these MCQs, then you can contact on these details, or you can check the description box, because in the description box the link for the subscription is there. So obviously there is a minimum fee that has been kept for its subscription, and that is ₹99, and that has been kept for the purpose of our motivation, so that we people can remain motivated to help you people. So if in case you are interested to join, do ensure that you check the description box for the subscription link. And lastly, you can also visit our website, that is www.achieveies.co.in, the link of which will also be provided in the description box. And here on this website you can get various types of information that you need for your preparation. So this is all about, friends, today's video. Thank you, have a very nice day ahead.